Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. Previously, we looked at various ways to import files with alpha channels. This included media with embedded alpha, as well as separate passes. Now that the media is loaded in Smoke, let's go ahead and combine the graphics with its background in a sequence. The first example we will look at is with the matte container. Remember, the matte container keeps the fill and its alpha together, which makes the graphics easier to composite as layers in Smoke. Now, it doesn't matter if the container was created when importing the media, or the matte container was created after importing the media, you can always key it in the sequence. So in this scenario, we have a sequence with a background on layer 1, and we want to key the title on layer 2. Looking at the media library, I'll select the matte container clip. You can identify it because it has a small icon next to its name. I'll drag and drop the matte container clip and snap it onto layer 2. As it currently stands, the graphic will not key itself through the background straight away. You can move the focus point up and down the positioner to look at the two layers. In order to key the graphic with its alpha on top of the background, you need to use the axis timeline effects. This is good to know if you're in a session and you have loads of graphics to layer over your video. Here are the steps. Right-click on the segment and choose to add effect. Apply the axis timeline effects to the clip. The graphic should now key through onto the background. In most cases, you should be able to scrub through it and preview the result. But ultimately, this will need to be rendered to create the final composite. Now, we all need graphics to fade up and fade down, so here's a small tip. All you need to do is add a cross dissolve to the beginning or end of the matte container segment. And now it's done. Let's rewind back and look at a slightly different scenario. This time round, I do not have a matte container. In the media library, I have my front clip. This is the RGB color channels. I also have the alpha channel in a second clip. Now, even though I don't have a matte container, it is still possible to key these elements in the sequence. Firstly, I drag and drop the RGB clip into the sequence and snap it to layer 2. As before, the RGB clip will not automatically key over the background. We need to use the axis timeline effects to help perform the key. Select and right-click on the RGB segment and choose Add Effect. In the Effects ribbon, choose the axis timeline effects. The bar under the top edge of the clip tells us that the axis timeline effects has been applied. Now we need to combine the alpha clip into layer 2 to correctly key the graphic over the background. In the basic parameters bar, click the button labeled matte. Now click on the alpha clip to select it. The graphic keys over the background to create the composite. So the axis timeline effects has created the matte container in the sequence, allowing it to keep everything neatly together for you. This is indicated through a color difference between the container clips and regular segments in the sequence. I will reiterate this one last time. To layer any RGB clips with alphas in the sequence, for graphics, credits, and external titling, Smoke will create a matte container, and that is just the way how it works. In the next video, we'll dive right into the matte container. We'll explore how it works, and how you can use this to your advantage to enhance your design work. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.